Hi, glory to God. Have you ever asked yourself, how am I supposed to make my day great? You know what? This is Pastor Peter this morning, and I'm bringing God's word to you, and I'll be showing you from scriptures how to make your day great. Glory to God. This morning, I'll be sharing from the book of Philippians chapter 4, and I'll be reading verse number 19, and it reads, it says, but my God shall supply all your needs according to his riches in glory by Christ Jesus. You see, this scripture, obviously written by Apostle Paul, but inspired by the Spirit of God, letting us understand certainly from whence our help comes from. You know, Apostle Paul, through the scripture, was communicating to us, letting us know the verity of the faith that we've received in Christ Jesus, letting us also understand exactly the same message that the psalmist by the Spirit was communicating in Psalm 23 when he declares, he said, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He make me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside still waters. He restores my soul. Yet though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, he said, I fear no evil, for God is with me. But the underlying truth that the psalmist was communicating was that the Lord is our shepherd, and the Lord is the one who provides for us, just like the shepherd provides for the sheep. It is his responsibility. And in the same vein, Apostle Paul, by the Spirit of God, communicating to the church in Philippi, and that which was true, or which is true for the church in Philippi, is true for you today as a child of God. He said, my God shall supply all your needs. Take note, he didn't say some of your needs, but he said all your needs. You know, as you woke up this morning, as you are set out, you're about to go out, or maybe you're already about your day, this is the mindset that you need to have. This should be your reality. This should be the mind with which you go out today. The mind of one whose needs are supplied. Hallelujah. The one who understands that his every need is supplied by heaven. Hallelujah. You see, he never leaves you alone. He never leaves you forsaken. God never leaves you as an orphan. He takes care of you as you trust him. As a child of God, you is born again. You have made Jesus Christ the Lord of your life. He takes care of your very need. So what is it that you need today? Maybe a job. Maybe you're going out for a business. Maybe you're going out for your academics. Or maybe you're thinking of how to take care of your family or how to take care of your business. It doesn't count exactly what the needs may be. Maybe it's about your health. But you know what? The Lord will supply all, not some, but all your needs according to his riches. Take note. I like that fact that he said according to his riches in glory, because it lets us know the reserve from whence he's talking from. It lets us know the reserve from whence the supply come from. And take note, that's that inexhaustible reserve of God's word. Hallelujah. Because it's the word that created the universe. If the word, or if the word of God, the spoken word of God, could bring the universe into being, and with all the resources that are in the world, take note, there is nothing that you need that he can't provide for you. Listen, if what you need is not even in existence, God will recreate or create that which you need. Yes, absolutely. Absolutely. Because his spoken word created the universe with every resource and all the wealth that are in the world. And there is nothing you will ever need that's not already in the world. But if peradventure there is a need, there is a miracle that you need that is not in creation, which is very much unlikely, but yet God is able to grant you that miracle. Why? Because he has his creative words. Hallelujah. You speak his word into your circumstance. You speak his word into your life. You speak his word into your health. You speak his word into your body. You speak his word into your family. You speak his word into your business. Yes, as you proclaim his word over your being today, you see creative miracles taking place in all that concerns you. Hallelujah. Apostle Paul declared in that scripture, he said, my God shall supply all, not some, but all your need. I pray for you this morning, whether those needs be financial, financial needs, they are met for you today as you go out. When are they be material needs, they are met for you today. When are those needs that you need has to do with your job, with your business, with your academics. Those needs are provided in the name of Jesus. Maybe you say, oh pastor, my need is about my head. There is a head situation in my body. I need a miracle right now. My heart, they said, is destroyed. My heart is not functional anymore. I need a new heart. Or I need a new lung. I need an intervention in my liver or in my kidneys. You know what? God is able to create miracles and is able to give you new kidneys, new heart, new liver, new organs in your body. Put your hand right there this morning as I proclaim that prophetic word of the Lord. Those areas of your body, those organs of your body, they are recreated right now by the power of the Holy Ghost. For my God shall supply all of your needs according to your riches in glory. You can go out today with confidence, such a confidence on God's word, because you can stake your life on God's word. It can never come back void. It can never come back empty until it accomplishes the purpose for which it has been spoken. You know why? Because God's word has in itself the ability, the creative ability to bring to pass what he talks about. And God's word to you today is that God is supplying all of your need. My God, all of your need according to his riches. Not according to the economy situation. Not according to the knowledge of medical science, not according to the knowledge of what the economy expert says, but according to his riches, according to his wealth of knowledge in heaven, according to his riches in glory by Christ Jesus. Those needs are met today. And you say, oh, pastor, maybe you are there and you are not yet born again. And you say, pastor, you seem to be talking only to those who have made Jesus Christ the Lord of your life. You know, the good news is that you too can become a part of this glorious family today by confessing the lordship of Jesus over your life. You can do that even now. You say, how am I supposed to do that? The scripture says, whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved, in Acts 2:21. And you can do that today. So just repeat this prayer after me, meaning it from the depth of your heart. You say, Father, in the name of Jesus, yes, repeat that after me. I come to you as a sinner, but I have heard your word and I believe that you sent your son Jesus Christ as the perfect sacrifice for my sin. Today I confess the lordship of Jesus over my life. From this day, I'm no longer for Satan and his kingdom. I am now for the Lord Jesus. He is the Lord of my life. I've been translated from the kingdom of darkness into the kingdom of God's dear son, and I'm born again. If you made that prayer from the depth of your heart, you were born again. Welcome to the family of God. I want to admonish you to look out for a Bible-believing church in the city where you live and ensure to join that church. And if peradventure live anywhere around Padova in Italy or in any of the adjoining cities like Ferrara, Vicenza, Rovigo, Bologna, or Mestre, or Venice, I want to invite you to come be our special guest at Healing Grace Christian Assembly, Via J Avanso number 17. Yes, just behind the Padova train station. You can't miss it. On Sundays, we have our Sunday school starting by 10 o'clock and by 11 o'clock, the main service. On Tuesdays, we have our Tuesday prayer meetings. Yes, where we agree with you for a miracle. And the time starts by 6:30. The service starts by 6:30 to 8 p.m. in the evening. We'll be looking forward to having you join us, so we pray with you for a miracle. And if by adventure you've not subscribed on our YouTube channel, the name is Peter Ashazobo on YouTube, ensure to get in touch and subscribe on that channel and turn on the notification bell so that when next we post our new messages, you'll be among the first persons to receive them. Yes, and do something good this morning. Ensure to share this message with at least 10 of your loved ones, your family members and friends, and help them start off a great day. Exactly. There is too much bad news in circulation. Ensure to share good news with your loved ones to encourage them to have a great day. Exactly. Do it now, not later. Do it now. Share the message with them and get them blessed and set them up for a great day. You know what? I want to wish you have a great day. God bless you.